In order to better manage project complexity, we need to know what strategies we can choose from. Therefore, let's look at management approaches that we recognize in nowadays projects. Let us first start with an example. The example is of the Betuweroute, a rail freight line in the Netherlands that was delivered in 2007. In the 90s, the railway line was planned and there was great opposition against the line. People didn't understand the need for this and said, "Not in my backyard." One of these problems was that the project was planned without sufficient interaction with stakeholders. We can show this in the following graph. In the graph, the horizontal axis shows the time, the vertical axis the level of detail. The project organization started to plan the line of the Betuweroute. They worked enthusiastically and sincerely, and soon they developed a basic design. They also started developing the plan into more detail to know all the consequences. At this point in time, they presented their design to stakeholders, such as citizens along the Betuweroute. These stakeholders now quickly needed to catch up in the design process. As can be expected, a conflict arose because stakeholders were not satisfied with the chosen detailed solution due to the fact that it didn't match their needs and expectations. And they were also dissatisfied because there was no interaction. They felt neglected. There's not much chance that they will come together. This is our first management approach, the internal approach. Better is to have more interaction, to align stakeholders, as you can see in this graph. They team up. Some years ago, we performed case studies into 15 large European infrastructure projects to investigate what management approaches were typically applied. The Betuweroute was one of these projects. Other projects were highways, high-speed lines, long tunnels, and waterways. At the end of the lecture, I will give an example of the West Coast Mainline. In the research, we distinguished four management approaches. The internal approach is one of these four. Interesting is that we can relate these four management approaches to detail and dynamic complexity. Maybe you remember that detail complexity is characterized by a high number of components with a high degree of interrelatedness, and that dynamic complexity is characterized by the potential to evolve over time and the limited understanding and predictability. When detail complexity is high, we say the system is complicated. When dynamic complexity is high, we say the system is complex. See the figure. When both are high, it is both complex and complicated. As mentioned, we can link four management approaches to this scheme. When both are low, we call the appropriate approach the internal approach. When detail complexity is high, systems management. When this is basic project management. When dynamic complexity is high, the suited approach is interactive management. And fourth, for the complicated and complex systems, dynamic management. We will reflect upon these four mainstreams. The internal approach is characterized by the absence of structured management. As we saw at the example of the Betuweroute, the focus on content is key. What we observed in our research is when this approach is used in our large projects, the results were bad, because the projects were not that simple. So, the result of the internal approach, decisions are unpopular with stakeholders without sufficient interaction with them. We found that this approach is still often used, for instance, in cases when something unexpected happened, project teams tend to be nervous and forget to interact and to look further than content. In general, there are various aspects that stimulate a content-focused approach. Lack of management attention, specialist project managers, financial tensions, organizations that are unfamiliar with each other, and a project team showing groupthink, so less variety. To summarize this approach, the key focus is on content and orientation is dominantly internally. Let's look at the second approach, systems management or basic project management. Systems management is characterized by decomposition in different aspects: time, end product, and organization, as well as certain management processes. Decomposition in time means that the project is divided in a logical sequence of phases, decision gates, and corresponding activities. Decomposition in end product means that the main deliverable is split up into various elements and sub-elements. Decomposition in organization means that the so-called work breakdown structure, WBS, is used to divide the work of a project into smaller, manageable pieces. This WBS can act as the basis for the organization breakdown structure, OBS, cost breakdown structure, CBS, and risk breakdown structure, RBS. These breakdown structures are used in corresponding management processes. Management processes are applied in order to complete the project, divided in phases within boundaries of time, cost, and quality. The basic management processes are schedule, cost, quality, and risks. The focus of systems management is on a rational and rigid control of these aspects. Systems management assumes that we can predict and control, but can we really? Can we really strictly control our projects? Reality is less straightforward and asks for interaction. This graph we already discussed is a good illustration of interactive management. With interactive management, we refer to a management strategy built upon alignment, redefinition of the problem and change of scope, using short-term predictability, and application of a variation in strategies, and by using what-if scenarios. When we look at interactive management, there are some pitfalls too. When stakeholders' wishes are tried to be met too much, this might result in lots of discussions, no decisions, no progress, and false expectations. Certainly, there are some tensions between the earlier mentioned systems management and interactive management. Whereas systems management is decisive, interactive management seeks for support. Systems management focuses on the hard results, and interactive management focuses on appreciation. Systems management focuses on content, whereas interactive management focuses on cooperation and external influences such as politics. Systems management focuses on stability, rigor. In interactive management, dynamics are anticipated. Hence, we need an approach that combines both: dynamic management. Dynamic management is a balancing act between systems management and interactive management. These different management approaches fit different types of complexity. We can illustrate this dynamic management by the example of the West Coast Mainline. Around 2003, the project is in big trouble. Massive cost overruns, dissatisfied stakeholders, and bad quality. Around 2003, a new strategy was presented that showed a fine balance between systems management and interactive management. The West Coast Mainline used an extensive consultation with stakeholders in which objectives were aligned of all stakeholders, such as railway industry, local authorities, NGOs, citizens, etc. The attitude towards stakeholders was: be absolutely open and honest in your communication, straightforward talking. Tell the stakeholders good news as well as bad news. The easiest thing is to create false expectation, but people will remember them. These lessons were also found at the other projects of our batch of 15 projects. So, we conclude: fit your approach to the complexities expected.